Hugh Jackman and the film Van Helsing. Superb. John Travolta and Battleship Earth. Breathtaking. Catwoman with Halle Berry. A revelation. How could this be, you say? There are no bad movies, only bad audiences. For every movie, there is an equal and appropriate audience for it. Yes, that's right. Because beauty is in the eye of the beholder, unless they are holding it too close. Which is what a lot of film snobs do. They think only they are the authority of cinema, which means they only go to the movies to critique and not enjoy movies. When they hate a film, they make sure you hate it as well. And worse, they want you to be ashamed if you like it, regardless of what they say. They've gotten so bad that they actually judge a movie by its length. Friends, if a movie is too long, then leave. It's not the movie's fault you've got the attention span of a squirrely, riddling child with attention deficit. No. And you want to know what the sound of one hand clapping is? Me smacking you in the face for saying you hated a movie you haven't even seen because of a trailer. Mercy.
And another thing. Could you folks stop harping on how much y'all couldn't stand the prequels to Star Wars? They were good movies, I thought. They were very entertaining. And stop blaming that little boy for all the movies being so bad. He was a cute little boy. He did exactly what he was supposed to do. He was supposed to be a little boy. What were you expecting, Shakespeare out of him? And can y'all explain to me why y'all didn't like that first Hulk movie? I thought it was great. I mean, what does it mean when somebody says it was too smart for its own good? What does that mean? How can a movie be too smart for its own good? Isn't being smart a good thing? Lord.
So go out and find yourself a copy of There Are No Bad Movies, Only Bad Audiences, and can the snobby attitudes at the cinema, y'all? Available exclusively through Amazon.com. Yeah.